population is expected to grow by 2 billion people, and the numbers are quite interesting. In the next three decades, from 7.8 billion to 9.7 billion in 2020. And the life expectancy has also increased. Humans are living longer now than ever before. The increase has been by 6 years, more than 6 years, between 2000 and 2019, from 66.8 years in 2000 to 73.4 years in 2019. While this is good news for humans, it does put a lot of pressure on Earth. How do we balance the two?
I would say the only two solutions which we can implement right away. One is recycling. We have to recycle everything. The second most important thing is renewable energy. We have to have 100% of the energy that we use will come from renewable sources. If you can do these two things, I think the problem is solved.
Yes, that would be ideal. But analysts are also predicting a steady decline in global population in the next century. And again, the trends are interesting. Countries like Japan and Italy are looking to increase their birth rates. In 2015, the Chinese government was forced to end its controversial one-child policy after the birth rates declined. And India is already witnessing a significant decline in total fertility rate over the past 70 years. We don't even have policies like the one-child policy. Do you believe that India is on the right track when it comes to a population strategy, if we have one?
I would say partly yes, because first we have to stabilize the population. In the end, we have to reduce the population. The population of India during independence was 350 million. Today, it's 1.3 billion. And that's four times. The land hasn't increased, the water hasn't increased, but there are four times as many people to inhabit the same area, the habitat, the same number of jobs. Maybe the jobs have increased, but it puts a pressure on everything.